Welcome to the Capital Region Education Council's 48th Annual Fall Staff. Please stand for the National Anthem, performed by Tom Reed Swale, STEM coach at Discovery Academy, and Elizabeth Reed Swale, music teacher at the Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Elementary School.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
I'm happy when I'm doing math.
My favorite teacher helps me with math and writing.
I'm happy at my school.
I love the experiences I get here at Crack.
I am happy at PSA.
We love our teachers.
They're very kind and they help me learn a lot.
Our teachers are the best.
My English teacher inspires me to try my best.
Science.
Technology.
Engineering. Arts.
And math.
Open Choice rocks.
Go PSA Eagles!
I love the sciences because they could be applied to today's world and the future world.
I can learn a lot and earn this way.
My school makes sure our students rock it.
Crack staff rocks.
I'm the future of Crack.
Mi escuela me hace feliz.
I love my school.
I'm happy with my school because everyone here supports and helps each other.
I love my teachers. They're very, very nice.
My favorite subject is music because our music teacher is very nice. She lets us play games and helps us with our voices.
Our mentors make us happy.
I like working through school.
I like my school because it's really fun to learn.
I'm very happy at Open Choice.
The Open Choice program gives me something to look forward to every summer.
I love my school because we always do fun things.
My school is number one.
My teacher cares about everybody and she's nice.
I love my teachers because they teach me things I didn't know.
Always helpful and understanding.
I love my teacher!
I like my school because the lunch ladies, they serve our food with a smile.
Thank you for all you do.
Have a great school year.
Gracias por todo.
Have a great school year.
Welcome back to school!
From the class of 2016, have a great year.
Hope you had a great summer.
Now get back to work.
From your leadership team, have a great school year.
And now, please welcome this morning's Masters of Ceremony. Chad Williams Bay, Student Services Coordinator at the Academy of Aerospace and Engineering High School, and Michael Collins, Humanities Teacher at Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies.
Good morning, everybody! Wow, there's a lot of you. Welcome to Falstaff Live. My name's Mike Collins, and I'm psyched to be one of your MCs for today's event.
And I'm Chad Williams Bay, and I'm thrilled to be one of your hosts for this morning's Falstaff.
Well, this is it.
We're here.
We're at Falstaff. But what is Falstaff? I've always thought of it as a way to gear up for the new school year. Summer vacation door closes, and the doors to each Crex school swing open.
Falstaff is a way for us to ring in the new school year to recognize where we've been, where we are, and where we're going.
Yes, grassroots to growth, cultivating a better future. That's the name of the game. And even though we're not farmers, we do have a few things in common.
Mike, farmers, how so?
Well, we each get up at a very ungodly hour of the morning to start work. Farmers plant little seeds that eventually are harvested. Every single one of you in this room plays a role in planting little seeds of education in the minds of children. Seeds which, over time, lead to a better future.
I guess I can see where you're going with that. But I hope that we're not gonna have to start wearing overalls and straw hats and looking like you and your wife.
Wow. I think I look pretty good as a farmer, but probably we'll stick to casual Fridays on that one.
Fair enough. Let's check in with this morning's top stories.
Let's do it. As always, CREC's executive director and fearless leader, Dr. Bruce Douglas, will be in the house. But the real question is, which Bruce Douglas will make an appearance? Will it be clean-shaven mustache Bruce? Or will it be Yukon Wilderness Bearded Bruce? Only time will tell.
The correct council chair will be batting lead off and speaking first. Now, I know what you all are probably thinking. How can a chair talk? It's an inanimate object. Well, stop being silly. Chairs can't speak. By council chair, we mean Chris Wilson.
Having the word super anywhere in your title usually implies that you're not just good at something, you're excellent. Excellent. More on that later. Today, we'll be joined by Hartford Superintendent Beth Schiavano Navarez.
We're happy to have the commissioner here this morning. No, not that commissioner. We mean Commissioner Pryor, the Education Commissioner of the Connecticut State Department of Education.
Our final guest is kind of a big deal. He has many leather-bound books, and his home smells of rich mahogany. He's a champion of education, and he has a pretty fancy-looking signature, way better than mine. I've seen it. You might know him. He works in that big building downtown that says City Hall. Hartford's mayor, Pedro Segarra, will be here today. Woo!
Yeah. And from the CREC Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts, we have hip-hop group Julio Cruz, Reynaldo Garcia, Lucas Mikan, and Jerome Walker, which raises the terrifying question for me. Will I have to dance, and is this being filmed?
I certainly hope not.
No.
I have family here today.
Me too.
A recent study suggests that 100% of people enjoy listening to music. Shocking, I know. But after collecting this surprising data, we've decided that we're gonna play a different genre of music during each award category. And we're also gonna have a live performance by the Rolling Stones.
Woo!
That's a joke, guys. We don't have the budget for that. And when I asked Mick Jagger about this, he's quoted as saying, "Who the heck are you? And what are you doing in my house?"
That's fantastic, Mike. I've been saying for years that this show needs more cowbell. Today we also celebrate a plethora of achievements. Yeah!
Woo!
Today we also celebrate a plethora of achievements and recognitions amongst our colleagues. I mean, you'd think we were at the Oscars by well-dressed you all are this morning. Give yourselves a round of applause for all that good looking. Ooh, I like those shirts and ties and stuff. I
feel like I'm at a GQ event.
Seriously. So this morning, we're gonna have award nominees displayed on the screens to your left and your right. And with some winners in certain categories, they'll be coming to the stage. And no, despite I know you all are probably thinking, Frozen will not be winning awards this morning here. Let it go, let it go.
Let it go.
No, I'm just gonna let it go.
Sorry, I thought we were gonna break out the song there for a minute.
No song.
All right, well, in order to shed some light on the meaning of each of these awards, special guests will be coming up to the interview table. And while Chad and I, we lack the qualifications and assumptions and everything with the Lenos and the Lettermans of the world, we're really gonna do our best to make sure that you, our very well-dressed audience, will be in the know when it comes to all of these well-deserved nominations.
Character, leadership, responsibility, and teamwork. Cultivating a better future is not possible without instilling these qualities into our children. But these seeds are not always planted in the classroom. Sports play a major role in molding kids into model citizens, and Crex athletic program has come a long way in just 2 short years. Now in its 3rd year of existence, the Capital Region Athletic League will take its talents not to South Beach, but to the football field. A few Crex Colt football players will join us on stage later to discuss this exciting upcoming season. Fun fact, I actually was asked to try out for the team, but the mere thought of running for extended period of time has actually made me quite shocked, and I would have been gone with a case of dizziness, so.
I'm actually getting a little dizzy just thinking about it, actually. Crex's successful Stuff the Bus program took place today. Each year, Crex collects school supplies and backpacks and distributes them to our own students as well as students within the community. Huge thank you to everyone who was able to donate. And I know what all you high school teachers are thinking, please, please let that bus be filled with writing utensils. They never remember them. They try so hard.
Lastly, we'll be holding a raffle based off of this morning's registration. So if you forgot to register, great, more room for us, and it's a better chance for us to win. And when it really makes me feel alive from Hartford, Connecticut, it's Falstaff 48.
Here's your first guest, Dr. Bruce Douglas.
It's apparent I have to play a bigger role in preparing for Falstaff, so. Good. I want to welcome all of you here today. You know, before I begin, I want to take a moment to consider the intellect present in this room. Each year, when I stand before you, I'm overwhelmed by the sheer power of the individuals that make CREC what it is, a strong and stable, thriving non-for-profit that's serving the best interests of children and families in school districts throughout the Capital Region. Looking upon you humbles me, even scares me, and it reminds me of how capable we are as a group. CREC has grown to more than 3,000 employees. That means each of us have 3,000 colleagues, 3,000 supporters, and 3,000 people we can go to in order to help us through our biggest challenge. This situation reminds me of a little story, so I'm gonna break my first rule of the day and take a little risk here and move off the script. I just wanna tell you a story that's related to this. In the early 1970s, there was a Navy fighter pilot who was shot down over North Vietnam after 75 missions, combat missions. And he was imprisoned in North Vietnam for 4 years. He came back to the United States and he recovered, got his life together. And some 10 years later, he was in a restaurant with his wife. And this man walked up to him and said, "You're Lieutenant George Plum, right?" And he said, yeah, that's me. He said, "You flew off the Kitty Hawk, right?" "Yeah, I did." "You were shot down in North Vietnam, right?" "Yeah." "And you were imprisoned there for 4 or 5 years, right?" "Yeah, right. How do you know all this about me?" "I packed your parachute." So, George Plum thought about that. How many times did I pass this man on the Kitty Hawk? I never had chow with him. I was always eating in the officers' club. I wonder what he looked like in his bell bottoms, in his dungarees. I wonder what he was thinking about when he was down there in the bowels of the USS Kitty Hawk, putting the shrouds of my parachute together. I never knew who he was. So here today, we have 3,000 people in this room. All of us are interconnected. The other day I was talking with a group of administrators, and I realized that in that room, there were several administrators whose children were transported to school every day by another administrator in the room, and they didn't know each other. And at the beginning of the meeting, they didn't take the time to get up and introduce themselves collectively to one another. So that's the kind of thing that we have to do. You have to ask yourself every day, you know, who packaged your parachute today? There's about 50 people who package my parachute every day, starting with Locke when I walk in the front door of Crec. They cover my back, okay? And I hope that I cover their back too. So this is a large group of people that need to get to know one another better and appreciate one another. We are a team of 3,000. We have to be more interconnected, and we have to get to know one another better. So when the time comes that I need my parachute, or I need that bridge, or I need that telephone call answered in the best interest of children, that someone in central office or in operations or in school construction or at one of our magnet schools picks up the phone and says, "Hi, I'm here to help you." So let's think about that as we move through this year. When I have a problem, I look to you to help me solve it. Each year, as an individual and as an agency, we're faced with new challenges. And it's this think tank of individuals in this room who have helped us overcome each trial, conquer every challenge, and take our work to the next level. Falstaff is a tribute to all of you, all that you've accomplished, and a celebration of the year that we just went through and the year to come, and as a reminder of all that we are capable of. I'd like to start by recognizing some of our guests and members of the Crec Council who are here today. Today with us is Jeremy Grievenson from the Glastonbury Public Schools, who's on the Crec Council, Lydia Tadone, who represents the Simsbury Public Schools, Don Harris, my good friend, colleague, who represents the Bloomfield Public Schools, and my good friend, Chris Wilson, who represents the Bristol Public Schools. And I'd like to thank all the Crec Council members for their unselfish and significant contributions to the Capital Region. They serve their local school districts and the entire Crec region in a voluntary capacity, often taking valuable time and energy away from their families and their friends and their weekends to work for the betterment of their community in which we all live. We're grateful for your commitment. Thank you all so much. We also have some birthdays among us yesterday and today and tomorrow. And so I want to say happy birthday to Cindy Mansigian, Adam Morris, Mary Jean Yanko, Stacy Pringle, Shante Robinson, Jorge Rodriguez, Heather Sullivan, Mark D'Alessandro, Meryl Ebner, Francine Gintoff, Michael Gonzalez, Tanisha Harvey, Geneva Jackson, John Randolph, Geraldine Santiago, Sarah Seals, Lauren Sundarini, and Heidi Turgeon. Happy birthday to you all. And so one of the people who packs my parachute is here with us today. She's a fourth grade teacher at Reggio Emilia School, and I just learned that she got married just a few weeks ago. So congratulations, Caroline Mooney. Congratulations. I would also like to acknowledge the generous sponsors who are supporting our event today, many of whom also support our work throughout the entire school year. I want to thank them for their generosity and their donations. And without them, this Falstaff would not be possible. A special thanks to our major sponsors, ORRL, BL Companies, Wells Fargo and Transamerica, Project Technologies Group, and most importantly, Nora Cupcake Company. Say Nora Cupcake Company 10 times. All right, good. All right. I tried that last night and I screwed it up again. All right. What an amazing year we've had. I'm happy to announce that for the third year in a row, Crec will be recognized by the Hartford Courant as a top workplace for 2014. Our employees have created a culture that ranks Crec as one of the best workplaces in the state of Connecticut. It's quite an accomplishment, and it reflects the culture and the community that you've all created. This year's Falstaff, like those before it, is meant to celebrate that which makes this agency truly great, you. I'm constantly amazed by the caliber of individuals working at CREC. Many of you heard me say there's hardly a week that goes by that I don't meet some remarkable and inspirational individual. I'm constantly amazed by the caliber of individuals of CREC. Each year, you reach higher, you innovate more, you push yourself to the edge of what is possible, and then you push yourself beyond that which we thought was not possible. I commend you on that. 2013 and 14 was another great year for us. Our budget has grown to over $500 million. Our significant growth is a testament to your hard work. The work that we provide for our children and our school district has expanded tremendously. Our growth is evident by the large numbers of families and residents served by our community education program, evidence of children having access to magnet schools and open choice, evidence of more children having access to student services program, inter-district grants program, evidence of more teachers and staff getting professional development at high quality, services for our teaching and learning unit, our DART unit, TABS, and evidence of the growth of our cooperative purchasing programs, transportation, food services, operations divisions, and evidence of the growth of our construction projects and services. All of the growth has increased the demands on our human services, business services, executive services, and communications departments. So there you go. Did I cover everybody at CREC? All right, good, good, all right. Usually after this part of the speech, I get punished a day later because I didn't recognize one of us. But I think I got everybody this time. And all of this growth is proof that the demand for our services continues to increase. It's proof that we're recognized not only for our ability to think strategically, act tactically, but more important, we're known for delivering on our promises. Together with the fine minds in this room, we are a powerful think tank. We are smart and you are capable. But what sets us apart from others in this field is your action. We get the job done, we move quickly, and we always do what is right for the best interests of children and families and the school districts that we serve. Together, we have effectively navigated the growth to where we are today. We've increased our impact potentially and expanded into new areas. But our growth has been planned, it's strategic, because most importantly, as we've expanded our workforce, we have continued to provide a secure work future for all of our employees. As this economy slowly recovers, the state of Connecticut and our member districts continue to face significant challenges. School districts will continue to rely on us to help them provide great educational programs for their children. Remember, the reason CREC was created and contributes to our school districts and we continue to exist is to support our member districts and the children and families they serve. We must maintain our commitment to ensuring that the limited resources of our region continue to be equitably distributed and serve as many children and families as possible. No matter what role you fill here at CREC, you have the opportunity to make a significant difference in the lives of children and families. This is what we are all about. Today, we celebrate members of the CREC community who have exemplified CREC's core values. The theme of Falstaff 48, Grassroots to Growth, Cultivating a Better Future, is about commitment of our staff to helping our districts and our students and our communities realize a better future. In recognition of the great minds that make up CREC, I'm excited to announce two new opportunities available to the CREC community. Thanks to the generous support of ORNL, CREC has developed the ORNL Innovation Fund to provide grants to the CREC community for innovative ideas that support teaching and learning and services to children and families. These grants will be awarded to individuals or groups, teachers and students, employees throughout CREC. The goal of this fund is to encourage bold thinking and to allow innovation to thrive within our community. We want to create a culture of bottom-up innovation and top-down facilitation. Because our staff are some of the most talented and talented problem solvers in the world, CREC has partnered also with the Peace Corps to provide exciting opportunities for CREC staff to pursue a common mission of the Peace Corps and CREC throughout the world. The Peace Corps is a preeminent international service organization of the United States, sending Americans abroad to tackle the most pressing needs of people around the world. Peace Corps has a program called the Peace Corps Response. It is a program that offers short-term placements, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, or a year, that harnesses the specialized skills of seasoned professionals in targeted areas around the world. We've developed a program that allows full-time CREC staff in all certified and non-certified positions to take advantage of these unique opportunities. I hope you take the time to learn more about this program. If you're interested, please contact our communications division for more information. Perhaps you and I will go abroad together. I'm enthusiastic about the direction that we're going. I see great promise and potential for even greater results. This year, we've expanded our reach and reinvested in our mission. We formed a strong partnership with the Hartford Public Schools and extended our partnership with the City of Hartford. It's a partnership that has firm roots and will bear the fruit for many years to come. As always, our success breeds challenges and opportunities. Our strength can be our weakness if we allow ourselves to become too comfortable with our success and accept complacency or institutionalization. Our fellow districts are stepping up to the game and competing with us, evidence that they're doing great things as well. Local school districts are beginning to develop new science programs, engineering programs, international studies programs to compete with our magnet schools. The students in these towns will now have more opportunities as a result of the establishment of these magnet schools. This rivalry is good for children. It is good for families. It is good for communities. And it is good for public education. We must have an optimistic and energetic yet cautious approach to our work. We must be adept at preventing institutionalization, be ambitious in our thinking, yet grounded in our actions. We must listen to the naysayers and the critics for opportunities for self-improvement and reflection and move forward with an intentional response. Those who see our success as a threat must be treated with extra decency and encouraged to become partners in our work because we are collectively doing the right thing. Our work has had far-reaching effects on thousands of children, thousands of families, working with thousands of teachers. This is a responsibility that we cannot and will not take lightly. We must leave no stone unturned. We must have the humility to know what is best and the courage to do what is best. And we must do whatever it takes to ensure that all children in the Capital Region have the opportunity to achieve at a high level. I would often make this comparison with a doctor. When you go into the emergency room, the nurse does not say, "What town do you come from?" All children in the state of Connecticut are important to each and every educator in the state of Connecticut. We serve all children. Yes, we have 169 towns in the state of Connecticut, right? But as educators, we have the responsibility to serve all children who come before us and reach out to every child who needs us. It was equally important that we support each other to grow and advance. Empathize with your colleagues. Celebrate our successes. Be part of the solution and help us to overcome our shortcomings. Take care of yourself and take care of one another. Take this moment to look around you. I ask you, do you belong in this room? I ask myself that question every day. You and I are sitting in the presence of a most powerful group of individuals. The people in this room possess great intellect and capacity and potential. What allows each of us to belong in this room is an intense commitment. One word, intense commitment. An intense commitment that we share to the mission of CREC, serving the best interests of children and families and service to our partnering school districts. I implore you to be part of that and to share in the impact that it has on children and families as well as all of us. So welcome to Fall Staff 48. It's going to be a great day and let it be a great year. Thank you so much. Now I'm very pleased to introduce a friend of mine. I don't know if you know what it's like to stand up here in front of 3,000 people and make this presentation. Imagine it. I was asking a friend of mine just recently, I said, what would it be like for you if you had to stand up in front of all of Crack and give this presentation? The person said to me, I would begin my presentation with, and then faint before the podium. Then we'd have to haul the individual out in a wheelbarrow, arms and legs splayed, right? That's what I feel like, and I'm sure that's what my guest, my friend, is going to feel like also. So I'm pleased this year to introduce our special guest for this morning's Falstaff celebration. Our success at CREC has always relied on the guidance and support we receive from our many partners and mentors, and especially members of the CREC Council. We're proud to serve the CREC Council and the Hartford Area Superintendents Association and their many constituents, and we'll continue to work every day to achieve the high goals they expect for us. The CREC Council has been CREC's guidance and our support system for many years. It's through their leadership that we get our direction as an agency, and we're grateful for the commitment they show our students and the families of the greater Hartford region. And I'm pleased this year to welcome the new chair of the CREC Council, Mr. Chris Wilson of the Bristol Public Schools. Chris serves on the Board of Education in Bristol. He's an extraordinary man. He's a great friend of CREC and is a personal friend of mine. We hold Chris in very high esteem for his intellect, his judgment, his common sense, and especially his integrity. Furthermore, he's forthright and he's honest. Given my 45 years of experience working with Board of Education members and municipal leaders, I know Chris to be a remarkable, strong, and intelligent leader. So I welcome Chris. Would you please come up? Thank you. Chris Wilson.
Thank you so much, Bruce. You're always so kind with your comments to me. I'm not sure I live up to them. And as you were saying, you weren't sure you should be in the room. I was thinking to myself, I'm not sure I should be on this stage. But be that as I may, I'm here, and I'll try to give you a few remarks. You know, I was thinking as Bruce had his song coming up here, what would be my song if I came up to the plate? And it would probably be Let It Be or Aquarius. Most of you are too young to even know what those songs are or were, but you know, be that as it may. This is probably my favorite event that I come to each year as a part of a CREC Council member, because when you come into the room and into the lobby, I'm not sure whether it's the acoustics here or it's the 2 months that you all haven't seen each other, but the energy, the vibe, the juice, whatever word you want to use in that lobby is just amazing. You can just see how much you care for one another, how much you care for your students. It just emanates out from you. It's just you know, an amazing event. So I'm always pleased to be here. As you know, there are 35 towns that are represented by CREC, and Bristol is one of them. And I can say over my 11 years of being on the council, I've certainly gained more knowledge and information and everything to be a better board member. And that's why I've stayed engaged. It's because I think it makes me a better board member in Bristol, being a part of this organization. I'm always thankful for the administration for providing me that support. I am just astounded by this organization. As Bruce mentioned, you're one of the best places to work in the capital region, and I would submit the best in Connecticut, and it's because of the talented people who care. You care so much for the students. You know, I was riding up to Boston. I'm a big Red Sox fan, and in fact, I'm going to be leaving here, so I'll apologize ahead. I'm not going to stay through the whole event because I'm getting on a plane to go to Tampa to see a few games. I apologize in advance. But this Tuesday, I was driving up to Boston, and I had my 9-year-old son in the car with me because I was going to take him to a game. And I was asking him, you know, are you glad to be going back to school? And he's like twisting, and, you know, he is so excited to get going back to school and see his friends and go to school. And I got to thinking, that's what each and every one of you experience next Wednesday, is those students that expect some kind of magic to happen in your classroom. And you deliver on that magic. And so it's just so great to be a part of an organization that cares about students. And it's not just curriculum, and it's not Common Core, and it's not teacher evaluation. What you provide, we can't measure. You provide that motivation, that nurture, that gentle tussle of the head saying you can do it, encouraging our students to try and try again. Or sometimes you even give them that cold stare. You know, I've been in my daughter's first grade teacher at IMS, and I've been in her classroom a couple times. And, you know, she has this rain stick, and I was thinking we might have to use the rain stick to quiet you all down this morning, but that didn't happen because Aura and Dr. Douglas, you really quiet down for them. But, you know, and I've been in her classroom, and I see all that energy that the students have and how you teachers have to captivate that energy. And sometimes it does take a cold stare. But more often than not, I see you giving that nice, gentle touch to the student. You point them in the right direction. You encourage them. You nurture them. And that's what's great about CREC. And so I'm so pleased to give you a few comments this morning. Thank you for allowing me to be on the stage. I probably have no right to even be here, but thank you very much.
Cool guy, huh? Genuinely good. Now I'd like to introduce another new colleague of mine. You know, every day I get the opportunity, as I said, to meet remarkable and inspirational people. This is a remarkable and inspirational lady, Dr. Beth Narvez. Dr. Beth Narvez is the new superintendent of schools in Hartford, and I invited her here so that you would all get an opportunity to meet her. Okay? We are strong partners with the Hartford Public Schools. Dr. Narvez joined the Hartford Public Schools as superintendent in July and has already demonstrated a steadfast commitment to infusing the Hartford schools with a culture of high and consistent expectations. Prior to her appointment at the Hartford Public Schools, Dr. Narvez served as deputy superintendent of support and improvement for Montgomery County Public Schools in Maryland, big school system. As assistant superintendent and chief academic officer, she also served the city of Springfield Public Schools. And she's been a teacher, an administrator, and she served in the Peace Corps and as a Fulbright Scholar. Congratulations. Dr. Narvez has been recognized for her leading work in central office transformation and support of schools. She's known for her collaborative style and engaging style. She has the qualities to become the cornerstone of collaboration with CREC. Today, the Hartford Public Schools, the City of Hartford, and CREC have signed, together we've signed, a memorandum of understanding that will lead to a dramatic change for the City of Hartford. Like CREC, Superintendent Narvez is committed to being part of a partnership that is focused on action rather than conversation. We are due partners, we are not thought partners. This partnership will have great results for children and families in Hartford. I'm very pleased and very proud and extraordinarily happy to announce this new partnership and thankful to Dr. Narvez for her willingness to be with us today. I want to introduce to you my new friend, Beth Narvez.
I like that, do partners. Since we're talking theme songs, Chairman Wilson, I think my theme song for today is happy. Just happy to be with you all today, happy to be in the city of Hartford, and very happy to be the leader of the Hartford Public Schools, and very happy about the new partnership with CREC. And even though you gave me the super reference, I don't wear a cape, and I don't do this work alone. None of us can do this work alone. Good morning, CREC community. And I want to thank you, Dr. Bruce Douglas, for this kind invitation to be with you today to celebrate the CREC staff, students, and partners. I'm thrilled to hear about your new partnership with the Peace Corps, as well as I was a Peace Corps volunteer in the Republic of Kiribati in the Central Pacific. It's also my honor and pleasure to join Mayor Segarra, Commissioner Pryor, the CREC Council members, and all of you here today. The title of this Falstaff event, Grassroots to Growth, Cultivating a Better Future, is both timely and appropriate. If you're like me, the start of the school year is a time of renewal and reflection. It is an opportunity to recommit ourselves to the ideals and values that drive our practice, to remember why we entered the field of education in the first place. It is also an opportunity to acknowledge the immense power we have in cultivating a better future for our students and their families. As the new superintendent of the Hartford Public Schools, I begin this school year both energized and excited, just a little bit nervous. Everyone I've met over the past several weeks, teachers, administrators, parents, business leaders, community members, elected officials, and others, have all echoed the same sentiment. We are here for the students. This is a community that puts the needs of students first, and that's why I'm here. The greater Hartford community is a very special place that is not afraid to try new approaches to improve students' experiences and outcomes in order to raise achievement. This is a community that understands and lives out the idea of shared leadership, the concept of collective responsibility. We need only look at the new partnership between CREC and Hartford Public Schools and as an example of that shared responsibility. And together, we share a new important goal to serve the students and families of the John C. Clark Jr. Elementary and Middle School. I can't wait to get there on Tuesday. I believe that by working collaboratively with a laser focus on meeting the needs of every student, we can and will ensure that all students thrive and all schools are successful. The type of partnership that CREC and Hartford Public Schools has developed is at the heart of the district's portfolio strategy, where we focus on designing and nurturing high-quality educational environments for our students based on their needs and interests. I know that as partners, we will work hard to provide the very best educational experiences for all students and all families at the Clark School and across the region. And as the title of this session notes, this work begins at the grassroots level. This partnership is an important component of my focus on equity, ensuring that all schools are great, that all achievement gaps are closed, and that each and every student thrives. This is an exciting moment as we work in unison for the children of this region. Together, we have the opportunity to build on the progress that has been made in this district and region, and at the same time, to ensure that we are living up to the promises that have been made to our children. Collective responsibility, shared leadership, starting at the grassroots and building a better future for all of our students. As we inaugurate the 2014-15 school year, I am happy to stand side by side with Dr. Douglas and all of you as we advance our shared purpose that every student and every school thrives. I wish you a wonderful year ahead. Thank you for all that you do every day for our students and families. Thank you.
She's a spitfire. Great things are going to happen in Hartford. So now I want to introduce to you a friend of mine. In fact, if he was my next door neighbor, we probably would be best friends. I share his values and I share his belief system. Stephen Pryor, Commissioner of Education in the state of Connecticut, arrived in Connecticut with the intention of elevating the education profession in our state. He emphasized that doing so would mean doing a far better job of preparing, attracting, developing, evaluating, coaching, recognizing and rewarding and advancing the quality of teachers and especially leaders in our school systems. I think CREC knows a thing or two about that. The commissioner has been a supporter of CREC, a strong supporter of CREC throughout his tenure. He has supported the expanding role of CREC and used CREC as an example of what high-quality early childhood education programs can do. He's asked CREC to play a role and a major role in the rollout of the Connecticut Common Core Standards, the Smarter Balance Assessment Consortium, and the statewide system of evaluating educators and administrators. Recently, he has supported our partnership with the Hartford Public Schools and our involvement in the Clark School turnaround effort. We're grateful to have the commissioner here with us today to share a few words. Stefan, welcome.
All right, good morning. What a fantastic gathering. Look at this assembly, fantastic. I'm so pleased to be here. Now, I'll let you in on a secret. One of my life's goals has been to be on Saturday Night Live, SNL. And I look up at the logo, FSL Live, and I think this is as close as I'm ever gonna get. So I'm gonna subject you to my routine. So, Beth, Bruce, and Stefan walk into a bar. I don't actually have a punchline for you, but I thought you'd enjoy that. It really is a terrific pleasure to be with you this morning. I am so proud of what you, the CREC community, accomplish every single day for our young people. It is breathtaking. It is breathtaking. It is not coincidence, it is intentional that we have engaged in so much work together over the past 3 years. I am concluding my tenure as commissioner, and I have to tell you that one of the great things that I will look back upon is the collaboration with CREC. You, as a RESC among RESCs, have charged forward and generated educational excellence for the students that you serve and that we serve. In my first year at CREC, you served 5,634 students. This year, you will reach 8,314 students, an increase of 2,680 students, Bruce Douglas. Well done, Dr. Douglas. Well done, CREC community. Incredible. We've opened 3 new schools together. We've expanded programming dramatically. Dr. Douglas has already outlined it, but you have led the way on multiple fronts. You have shown the way on educator evaluation and professional support, what it takes to ensure the right kind of professional dialogue and professional community. You have led the way in ensuring opportunities for all of our youngsters, no matter their background or zip code. You have led the way in showing that wonderful, integrated, high-quality schools can excel not just in this region, not just in Connecticut, but by national standards. Now, I'm gonna offer a bit of a hit parade. You know some of these things, but I think they're worth saying out loud again. Just in this past year, there were 2 schools of distinction, schools showing the highest progress in the state, in their category, in the CREC system. Where's Medical Professions and Teacher Prep Academy? Where are you? School of Distinction. Where's International Magnet School for Global Citizenship? School of Distinction. And I would argue that as a system, Dr. Douglas, yours is a system of distinction. Your CAP scores were up 3 points in the last statewide measure, 2012-13, which is significant. I'm pleased to report to you that CREC has contributed to a statewide trend. When you look at our high school students, students who are at the end of the process that you all engage in preparing our youngsters for college and career and for the world. When you look at the National Assessment of Educational Progress about Connecticut, with CREC as a key driver, for the first time in recent memory on the 12th grade NAEP, Connecticut is now number 1 in the country in reading. Number 1 in the country. We don't gloat over this, Dr. Douglas, but there are some neighboring states that may have been eclipsed in that instance. I won't mention them, Massachusetts. Sorry to those Red Sox fans who applauded earlier. We are beating that state. We were one of only two states that showed improvement among participating states on that 12th grade NAEP. And we were also among the highest performing states in the nation in the top category with statistically insignificant difference for mathematics. And very importantly, CREC leading the way on this point, but statewide on that high school NAEP, we for the first time in modern memory are closing the achievement gap between black and white students. The African-American white gap closed by 9 points on the last NAEP in reading. I am so proud of the collaboration that we have with CREC and of the leadership that you all exhibit every single day. It is truly remarkable. And I want to say something about Bruce Douglas. Bruce is a leader among leaders in Connecticut. He, in my view, is an educational icon. He is a true exemplar. He is a tough customer. He bargains hard. He recruits vigorously. He ensures the best for you, the faculty and staff of the CREC operation, and for the youngsters as a result. But Bruce also tells it like it is, shares his wisdom. He has helped to shape our educator evaluation support system, our supports for the reaching of Common Core standards across our state. He has offered personal advice and counsel to me. He is leading the way. And he's been doing it for more than 30 years as an educator in the state. Bruce, how many years as an educator in Connecticut? 45 years. Bruce Douglas. A couple of references have occurred to a new partnership of ours. Superintendent Narvaez mentioned it. I want to just say a word about Superintendent Narvaez. We've only had a few occasions to talk thus far, but I'm so encouraged by her nascent leadership and her vision. Clark School is a very important project. Clark School has been struggling for too long. There's enormous potential. There are great assets at Clark School, the traditional public school within HPS. But what CREC is doing under Bruce and Beth's leadership in partnership with the state is remarkable. The idea that a RESC, the idea that CREC in particular can step up and help to turn around a low performing school within the local Board of Ed traditional system, it's very important. Thank you for devoting resources to this effort, for doing it selflessly, for doing it in a way that's, I think that we can be confident is going to succeed. I'm going to try to stop by Clark later today. I understand that there are some ceremonies going on at that school, but 369 students at Clark Elementary are going to be the beneficiary of all that you do across all of your schools as you bring your wisdom to bear upon the traditional system. Thank you, Bruce Douglas, and the entire CREC organization for that fantastic body of work. You know, as I look back upon my commissionership, there's some commissionership left. But as I begin to look back, I am so proud of what we've all accomplished together. Again, you have offered so many of the best examples to help us get there. But together, we've raised standards consistent with the Common Core. We've established educator evaluation and support systems across the state. We have begun to turn lower performing schools around, schools we've known have been struggling for years and even decades, but we've gotten involved. We've expanded choice, public magnet schools, public charter schools, and others. We've established family resource centers and parent academies, and we've dramatically expanded early childhood educational opportunities, and we've created a new Office of Early Childhood that consolidates across state government all the efforts to undertake early childhood work. You all have raised the standards. You've set the bar. You are providing excellent education to young people. Please keep it up, because it makes a difference. The ripple effect goes beyond the CREC schools, beyond even this region, to the state and indeed the nation. Thank you for everything you do every day. Thank you.
So I just wanted to make sure that I didn't say this before I introduced Stefan, but only after. He's a Yankees fan. There you go. Yeah. That's not so great, right? That's not so great. I would like to introduce another friend of mine, but someone I admire very, very much. Since becoming mayor of the city of Hartford in 2010, Mayor Pedro Segarra has been clear about his mission, and that is to make Hartford a national model for urban reinvention by leveraging existing resources to attain economic security and create a nurturing and inspiring environment for all residents. In his tenure, Mayor Segarra has demonstrated his commitment to this great city time and time again, and he's looked to CREC to be a resource and a partner in helping him to make his vision a reality. In recent months, the Memorandum of Understanding, about which I spoke, signed by the mayor, has laid a foundation for a very robust relationship between the city offices, the Hartford Public Schools, and CREC. At this critical moment in Hartford's history, the joint memorandum brings attention to the long-standing collaboration and the relationships between us. Our individual missions have always been to do what is best for the children and families of Hartford. Now, this partnership will allow us to work together towards that end. This collaboration will not only bring immediate change for the people of this great city, but it will pay dividends well into the future. The city of Hartford is fortunate to have a mayor with the drive and the intellect and the compassion of Pedro Segarra, and we are fortunate to have him with us here today. Pedro, please.
Wow, I really do appreciate, and I can sense the energy that's out there. I want to thank you for what you do. I'm hopeful that you have had a good, wonderful, restful summer vacation, and I really look forward to this academic year. I am really very, very excited about this partnership between Hartford Schools, City of Hartford, and CREC. As a city that is still very much recovering from a bad economy, but more importantly, as a city that suffers one of the worst income inequalities in the nation, what this is about and what you do is about one clear thing, and that is, it is about opportunity. Opportunity for our children to be able to live lives that are productive, opportunities for our children to be able to succeed. So it was not a very difficult decision for me to make sure that the Hartford school systems, the city, and CREC could partner up in a very unselfish and dedicated way towards joining forces to make sure that our children succeed. So while Commissioner Pryor, who's here, I want to thank you for your courage and your leadership. I'm looking forward to working, continuing to work with Dr. Beth Chavano Narvaez and her leadership in our schools, and Mr. Bruce Douglas. We are going to continue to join forces to move forward. But more importantly, we also have to continue to join forces to not only work around education, but also be creative and think out of the box in terms of how we can create a better capital region. Hartford is the capital city, and as you've seen, we have been growing. We have been completing Front Street. UConn is coming to the city. We're in the process of building about 1,200 units of housing right around this area, and there's a lot more work to be done. But it all needs to be done to make sure that as we continue to grow our graduation rates, that we have opportunities for our children as they go on to college and come back to want to be in this area. So there's a lot of work to be done around economic development in this city. So Commissioner Pryor was doing a little bit of lecturing, so I'm gonna do a little bit of testing, and it's gonna be very easy, true or false, okay? So first question, Mayor Segarra's first professional opportunity in the city of Hartford was as a child development specialist with CREC, true or false? True. You might not have known that about me. Second question. This is the last one. I don't want to start testing too early. You know, people are saying that our children are being over-tested. I don't want the mayor to be accused of the same thing. Mayor Segura's salsa dance partner is Aria Alvarado. I hear a couple of ladies out there, some people say false, because they probably want to be my next salsa. I'm not giving up Aria. Hey, listen, I just want to thank you for being here. I really want to wish you the well. She's probably asking for a salsa song right now, right? Probably wants to come up on the stage and do a performance. Congratulations. Thank you for what you're doing. I look forward to working with you.
I'm so glad to see Aura get a little bit of it back. That's just wonderful. Good, good. She rarely blushes. This is very good. Good. Thanks, Mayor. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. I appreciate your kind words, but especially your comments about Aura. Thank you. All right, so I want to thank our speakers today. All right. They've shown that they are partners of ours. And in many ways, they pack our parachutes. We cannot do the work that we do today without the support of Beth Narvez, Pedro Segura, without Chris Wilson, without Stefan. Okay? They are the people who back us up and they help us. They believe in our mission, they support our mission, and they're in the same place we are. So I want to thank you so much. Thank you very much. So now I'm going to turn this over to our MCs, and I get to step down for a while. Thank you. Good. Take care.
Wow. So we got a big chunk out, so we're going to move on to the great, fantastic stuff. From the CREC Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts, we have Julio Cruz, Reynaldo Garcia,
Lucas Micah, and Jerome Walker. Let's give everybody it up for them.
thousand miles from comfort, we have traveled land and sea. But as long as you are with me, there's no place I'd rather be.
Let's give them another round of applause. The awesome talent we have at the Learning Corridor. Great job, guys, again.
It's amazing.
So now this is a perfect time to start celebrating the individuals who make CREC a great place. Now for the presentation of the Distinguished Service Award, I'm joined by Tim Nee, CREC's Assistant Executive Director. Hi, Tim, how are you?
Hey, Chad, good morning, everybody.
Good morning. The Distinguished Service Award is a prestigious award that only goes to one CREC staff member a year. Can you tell us a little bit more about the Distinguished Service Award?
Sure, Chad. The Distinguished Service Award recognizes CREC employee who, for a variety of reasons, have exemplified being an outstanding CREC employee.
Seems like we have a lot of staff out there, 3,000 people, who can be eligible for that criteria.
Each and every one of them could be. The employee, though, demonstrates performance that goes above and beyond the call of duty. They establish and maintain effective work relationships. They work cooperatively in supporting others and the achievement of their goals. They value the differences in all people, making extra attempts to influence events and achieve goals, exhibiting drive to develop and acquire and utilize new knowledge and skills, that innovation that Dr. Douglas was talking about earlier. These employees also demonstrate a positive outlook, always represent CREC in a professional manner, contribute to the goals of CREC and their programs, participate in CREC-sponsored activities that demonstrate this wonderful commitment that we see with all of you out there.
Sounds like some high standards. How many nominees did we receive this year for the Distinguished Service Award?
We receive countless nominees each year. This year, we have a wonderful list of 6 nominees for the Distinguished Service Award. Let's find out a little bit more about those people.
Distinguished Service Award nominees. Gerald Barrett, Institute of Teaching and Learning. Christina Burns, River Street School. Milda Hernandez, Regional School Choice Office. Rashida McKnight Watkins, Transportation. Maritza Morales, Hartford Region Open Choice Program. Nancy Penault, Montessori Magnet School.
What an amazing group of nominations from such an excellent employee pool. We want to congratulate all the nominees and thank them for all that they do for CREC and for the families and children that we all serve. Without further ado, however, I'd like to announce this year's Distinguished Service Award winner is Gerald Barrett from CREC's Institute of Teaching and Learning.
You know,
let's hear about Gerald.
CREC's core values are something that I believe strongly in: trust, leadership, diversity, quality, and collaboration. It's important to be good stewards of society.
It's not 20, it has to be 10. Okay.
Gerald, or G as we call him, is primarily responsible for gathering data, analyzing the data, and training people in the systems in order to collect the data. And to that end, you know, I think he represents, again, it's a very, very important skill.
I think Gerald exemplifies CREC because he really strives to be professional. He takes his role very seriously in helping a lot of different school districts, and people come to him for that reason.
He's constantly looking at ways to make it easier for his clients to be able to serve their clients. But the way that he delivers the information and the examples he gives open people up to new ideas. Not only do it in a way that is required, but that is meaningful. And I think that's what Gerald really does for the State Department of Education and for CREC.
One of the things that's so great about Gerald, he understands those connections. He gets the connections between how the community and the school has to work together.
Gerald Barrett exemplifies what we look for in every CREC employee, which is somebody who goes above and beyond and does what's best for children and the community, not only in Greater Hartford, but statewide.
I think Gerald is all about the kids. He knows that data is important, but he knows that what data collects is not always the whole picture of what's going on in the program, so he very patiently explained what we needed to do to make our program better. We listened, and it's really going very, very well.
The
better, so the grants are out right now.
Okay.
I think that we need to remind ourselves on a daily basis that these qualities will help improve the lives of the children and families that we strive to serve day in and day out.
And I just want to mention that in the area of packing parachutes, Gerald's mom and fiance are here today. Would you please stand?
Aww.
Congratulations. Thank you. Nobody packs a parachute like a mom. Thank you.
Congratulations, Gerald, and thank you, Tim. For our next award, I'm joined by Deborah Richards, CREC's Director of Student Services. Hi, Deb. Welcome to Falstaff.
Thanks. Good morning, everyone.
How about that hip-hop performance before?
Oh, it was wonderful. What great energy to start the school year, having students on stage.
I thought that was pretty awesome. It's probably what most of us think we look like when we dance at weddings. So, Deb, can you please tell us about the Paraprofessional of the Year Award?
Oh, I'd be happy to. A few years ago, we established a special award for our hardworking paraprofessionals and child care workers called the Paraprofessional of the Year Award. We currently have 283 staff working in these positions. We continue the tradition this year by recognizing our third distinguished paraprofessional. These people will also be eligible for the State Paraprofessional of the Year.
I know they certainly are a special group of people, very hardworking. What are the criteria involved in the Paraprofessional of the Year Award?
Oh, they're definitely hardworking people. Our student service programs and magnet schools rely on them to provide support to all our teachers and students. Actually, the criteria is the same as for the Distinguished Service Award. In their work, these individuals have exemplified what it is to be an outstanding CREC employee by establishing effective relationships, valuing differences, achieving goals, demonstrating a positive outlook, and much more. These individuals are truly committed to the CREC mission.
I'd say they certainly are. So how many nominees do we have this year?
We actually had 8 nominees this year. Let's hear about the nominees now.
Paraprofessional of the Year nominees. Carissa Benavides, International Magnet School for Global Citizenship. Kathy Dayton, Glastonbury East Hartford Magnet School. Kristen Goodwin, Reggio Magnet School of the Arts. Rima Manga, University of Hartford Magnet School. Janice Mitchell, Montessori Magnet School. Margaret Muscanel, Two Rivers Magnet Middle School. Maria Perez, Discovery Academy. Stephanie Rondinelli, River Street School.
And I'm pleased to announce this year's Paraprofessional of the Year Award goes to Maria Perez from the CREC Discovery Academy.
I love my job. I love just being around the children. I love what I do. I love just sitting with the children.
So I've seen Ms. Perez in the classroom. I've seen her working with the kids. She has that fine line of knowing when to discipline the kids and when to be loving and affectionate.
Maria is, she's the quintessential paraprofessional. She goes above and beyond in every aspect of her job. More than that, she does everything with a great spirit of kindness and generosity. The children adore her, the parents adore her.
Maria Perez is sunshine. She walks down the hall and she lights up everything around her.
Maria is, I think, one, extremely energetic. You know, no matter how tired she is or what's going on with her life, she comes in and she has this, you know, exuberance about her that's there for the kids.
During physical education class, she never hesitates to jump in. If I forget to ask her to come in and help me out, she's always like, Mr. Mancini, what about me? And I have to have her jump in and participate with the students.
Maria was one of the first paras that we hired and immediately moved to the ranks of being a leader amongst her peers. People went to her with problems and ideas because she always had a positive outlook on things and had great ideas and strategies to try. She's that person that you want to go to when you can't think of anything else to do. She's the one with the ideas.
And I also oversee the lunch in our classroom.
Because one thing I know that I've enjoyed as a parent about watching Ms. Perez is in the lunchroom, she knows what the kids like to eat, what they don't like to eat.
I like Ms. Perez a lot because she helps us out a bunch of times.
We love you, Ms. Perez!
Congratulations, Maria, and thank you, Deb. But we're just getting started with recognizing our great staff. So joining us to present our next award is one of the hugest, the most fantastic, the most exciting New York Yankees fan.
Not.
Sandy Cruz Serrano, CREC's Chief Operating Officer and Interim Chief Financial Officer. Hi, Sandy, how are you?
I'm good, thank
that's
you.
Good, that's good. So you're going to tell us a little bit more about our next award, the Manager of the Year.
The Manager of the Year award, Chad, is one that recognizes leadership at CREC and great managers, which God knows we have plenty of.
And what are the criteria for this award?
The criteria for this award is we're looking for managers who exemplify CREC's core values of trust, leadership, quality, diversity, and collaboration. And we're also looking for them to exemplify great management skills, and we're looking for people who motivate their employees.
That sounds like we have a lot of deserving candidates here. And how many nominees did we have this year?
Six. And why don't we hear their names right now?
I think we probably should.
Let's go.
Manager of the Year nominees. Ora Alvarado, Communications. Tim Barber, University of Hartford Magnet School. Phyllis Fiora, Transportation. Mike Henderson, River Street School. Robert McCain, Two Rivers Magnet School. Henry Munoz, Metropolitan Learning Center.
And the Manager of the Year is Ora Alvarado. Let's see that video.
For me, it's very important to motivate others, and I get that from my family upbringing. And I kind of instill that in my team, and people around here will be the first one to tell you that,
the list, which we already have.
So with that passion and that commitment that I see from the leadership team that I'm a part of.
So that part is now all happening.
And I see it every day. I see the impossible missions become a reality for the children and the families.
Ora is very passionate about the work she does at CREC and in the community. Everyone knows her in the Hartford area. They all love her. She's involved in everything. I've never seen such a hard worker as Ora. She's very committed to the mission and vision of CREC, and she is the perfect choice for Manager of the Year.
Ora is a firecracker. I think that's the best way to describe her. There are so many events at CREC that Ora has her hands in. A lot of people may not realize everything that she is the lead on, and I feel lucky to be part of her team.
I think CREC has made an excellent choice in naming Ora as our Manager of the Year. She is an intuitive manager. She is one of the people you encounter who really does very often see challenges as opportunities.
She's the go-to person for so much. People just say, I need something done, I need something fixed, I can go to Ora. And she still will have advice as how to approach the situation.
I think that Ora really exemplifies the values of CREC. I think that if anybody has a problem, a question, or a request, all you have to do is tell her and it gets done.
Ora is one of the most energetic and happy people at CREC, and part of that is that she really believes in the CREC mission. And in the Department of Communications, we are really integral to making sure that the agency is able to do that.
She's mentored me. I valued everything she's told me. She's very caring as far as her fellow employees.
She aspires to be outstanding at everything that she does. Excellence is her prevailing attitude in small things and in large things.
I am where I am today because I learned something from each one of you. And I'm here to make CREC better and provide a better future for our children and families.
Alrighty, let's give it up for our first three award winners. Worked so hard. So now we're on to the big to-do, the teacher. Mike.
What? Huh?
The Batman suit, Mike.
It's for the teacher. It's for the Teacher of the Year award.
Now, how does Teacher of the Year and Batman correlate? I don't understand.
What? It's teachers are like superheroes. They're, you know, they live double lives. They care deeply about what they do. They put themselves before other people. They wear capes.
He won't give this up. Capes, Mike. Capes.
Sorry, I got really carried away. Plus, this is way more comfortable than a suit and tie. I don't care what Justin Timberlake says. It's really comfortable.
I'll forget this. Anyways, let's give a warm welcome to our superintendent of Kreck Schools, Dina Kral.
Good morning, colleagues. As I prepared my remarks to recognize Kreck's Teacher of the Year Award and all the great teachers who have had a major impact on the success of the students here at Kreck, I find myself asking the question, what makes a great teacher different than others? What qualities do kids look for in great teachers? Is greatness learned or innate? So to answer these questions, we polled who else Kreck students. We had over 1,000 students in pre-K to 12 respond to our question of what makes a great teacher. While some students think that teachers are great because they live at school, they're really pretty, or because they give lots of extra recess, others offered insight that I think should be shared with all teachers. So the top three answers we received, the first one was, a great teacher explains things well, makes subjects interesting, and makes learning fun. One student stated that a great teacher shows us to use our own mind rather than to fill it with facts for a test. The second response was, a great teacher is funny, but also serious when they need to be. One student explained that a great teacher would be funny, friendly, entertaining, organized, and would teach in a fun but smart way. And the last popular response we got was that a great teacher is interested in what students have to say and is willing to work with students at the level that they are at, and they have high expectations not only for their students but also for themselves. So it's clear from the responses that we received from all these students that they like to know that someone is listening to them and that they are special. Kreck students like to take charge in the classroom, but they also like to look to the teacher for words of encouragement. Knowing a teacher believes in them makes all the difference. One student commented, "My teachers believe that I can succeed with the material that I have a hard time with, and they also motivate me to go on with the hard work, which makes it easier for me." So Kreck is very fortunate to have a group of educators that are different, a group of educators that are great. I'll be sending out all of the responses to you, probably before school starts, I'll send you, so you can take a look at all the responses we receive from students. So in the words of William Arthur Ward, the mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires. Our Teacher of the Year nominees are teachers that excel in inspiring others. They inspire their peers and their students to be better today than they were yesterday and better tomorrow than they are today. The nominees for Kreck Teacher of the Year were selected because they met the qualifications including showing evidence of positive effect on student achievement and demonstrating a strong ability to foster excellence in education. This year's nominees are a group of very special individuals. They represent the great work that happens in your schools every day. In addition to being recognized here today, our Teacher of the Year nominees were also recognized at a luncheon held in their honor. So now let's meet this year's nominees.
Teacher of the Year nominees. Bonnie Amato, Reggio Magnet School of the Arts. Laura Berent, Glastonbury East Hartford Magnet School. Hera Butt, Public Safety Academy. Joseph DePasqua, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Middle School. Stephanie Hall, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Peter Hybrex, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering High School. Eileen Kylie, Museum Academy. Allison Malerba, Soundbridge. Patricia Massetti, University of Hartford Magnet School. Kimberly Monroe, Metropolitan Learning Center. Janice Mooney Frank, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Elementary School. Carl Pastor, Two Rivers Magnet Middle School. Julia Porter, Two Rivers Magnet High School. Helena Richards, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts High School. Lindsay Russell, Montessori Magnet School. Lisa Smith Horn, Discovery Academy. Kara Strojewski, International Magnet School.
As you can see from your program, the Teacher of the Year Award has a long history of recognizing distinguished teachers at CREC for their unbelievable accomplishments in the classroom. This year's Teacher of the Year is no exception. Without further ado, we are excited to announce the CREC's Teacher of the Year for 2014, Joe DePasqua from CREC Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Middle School. And now a short video about this deserving teacher.
Having fun in a classroom is important, as long as it's leading to that they're learning, that they want to learn. I have a quote on my wall over there, and it said, "It's easy to teach children that want to be in your classroom. So make a classroom that kids want to be in." And that's hard work.
One of the things that I like most about Mr. DePasqua is that he really has high expectations for his students. Whether it's a small in-class project, a group project, like the John Brown trial.
Would you call Brown a madman?
Everyone has something amazing to say about Mr. D. He's dynamic. He's like no other teacher I've ever met before. Passionate, very passionate. There's not a single individual at this school that doesn't love him.
He brings out the spark in every student to learn more about his subject.
Joe has been a mentor to teachers. He has willingly assist teachers, and he's very encouraging to other teachers.
Great job the other day.
Thank you.
You
had a blast.
But you know, you can see, the connection how you make with kids.
I mean, he's been an inspiration not only to us first-year teachers, but to all the veteran staff. Basically, when you want some advice on how to be an incredible teacher, both in and out of the classroom, he's one of the people that I've always gone to.
I like this quote, "A ship in the harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are for." And I think that's important. If you want to do anything in your life, you have to stick your neck out there. One person can make a difference in a child's life. Your words are so important. If you were back 150 years ago, because that's hard to do. If you were back 150 years, would your view be different?
I really believe that he finds a connection to kids that is very rare, and he takes the time to really get to know children individually so that he can really understand what they need specifically as individuals.
He has brought more of a life to the classroom. He's a very exciting teacher, and I'm so glad that my son was able to experience him as a teacher.
So environment has an impact on how we even think. So sometimes changing the environment.
Mr. D understands us students. He knows what we are going through. Like, if we have a problem, we can always go to him.
Because he's an example. Yes, he's a great example.
The first time that I met Mr. DePasqua, I learned that he's genuine and passionate and willing to put himself out there.
I've been so blessed to be around young people because they motivate me. They make me want to be better.
Now please welcome to the stage CREC's Teacher of the Year for 2014, Joe DePasqua.
righty. How's everybody doing? Again, can we give a round of applause for Gerald and Maria and Ara and Joe for their wonderful service to CREC? Let's give them a round of applause. So now, we told you guys about those great raffle prizes, you know, if you didn't register. So sorry for you. So we're gonna go with our first set of raffle prizes. So our sponsor for this raffle is Advanced Corporate Networking, and it is for a HP Chromebook. So Mike is gonna assist me, and all righty. And the winner is from River Street School. Where are they at? River Street School. And make sure when we call your name, you stand up, or CREC Ambassador is gonna bring you the gift. We have Francesca Lopez. Francesca Lopez from River Street School. Can you stand?
Oh, I don't know. I think you have to go over there. It's over there. I think Kelly has it.
Again, remember, if you won the award, the gift, just make sure you stand and a CREC Ambassador will bring it to you. And this next gift, our sponsor is Access Transportation. And there's going to be a gift basket. And the winner, where's the University of Magnet High School? Where are they? Sorry, University of Hartford, pardon me. Sorry. And the winner is Christine May. Where is she? Christine May? Can you stand, Christine? Christine, stand so the CREC ambassador can. And our next sponsor is Anthem Blue Cross, and we have a smoothie blender from Anthem Blue Cross. And the next winner comes from Public Safety Academy. And that winner is Corey LaChance. Corey LaChance, can you please stand? All righty. And our next award comes from, our next gift comes from the sponsor of EE Smarts. And it is a 2-year-long pass to the Discovery Museum.
Cool.
And our winner, again, comes from Public Safety Academy.
Smells like conspiracy to me.
I don't know. He's ringing them. Antonio DeMello. Antonio DeMello. Congratulations, guys.
Remember, that's only our first round of raffles. We will be giving away more stuff later.
All righty, everyone. How's everybody feeling out there? We're feeling great? Feeling good?
Very energetic crowd. We love that.
All right, so the CREC Shining Star Program began in October 2007 as a way to recognize individuals throughout the year that exemplify CREC's core values through their service, teamwork, achievement, and respect for others.
These are individuals whose fellow colleagues have nominated them to acknowledge their efforts for going above and beyond their day-to-day duties, much like superheroes, just saying. Talented and dedicated employees like you are the reason CREC programs and schools successfully serve the students and families of the greater Hartford region.
This year's Shining Stars, they're acknowledged in the lobby, and their names will appear on the screen. Can this year's Shining Stars please stand, and let's applaud these extraordinary individuals.
Don't be shy. We want to see you standing up. Come on.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Fine light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of. I'm alive, we're like diamonds in the sky.
love that music. In 2011-2012, CREC recognized the need to have a talent management strategy to facilitate leadership development. In order to meet this need, CREC developed the Internal Leadership Development Program. And I know what you're thinking, another acronym for CREC.
This year, we celebrate the third graduating class from this demanding program. These dynamic individuals participated in discussions, experiential activities, and personal assessments. They were exposed to topic-focused articles and books that highlighted real people finding real solutions to real problems. In addition, the program offered the opportunity to be exposed to leadership issues and to broaden their understanding of CREC through personal engagements with various leaders within the organization.
The CREC Internal Leadership Development Program is a talent management strategy to facilitate leadership developed by offering experiential training and the tools to develop leadership skills. The program is available to non-certified CREC staff in the support staff or professional job classifications. Chad, weren't you a member of that graduating class?
I actually was, Mike.
Very nice.
And at this time, I'd like for everybody else who participated in the Internal Leadership Development Program, the third graduating class, to stand and can we please applaud these leaders and their success.
We are the champions, my friends. And we will keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the world.
And we'd also like to take this opportunity to ask the CREC ambassadors to please stand. Let's acknowledge our ambassadors out there. Woo, woo.
Moving right along. Following the theme of grassroots to growth, can you believe that CREC never had a sports program until 3 years ago?
It's very hard to believe.
Now we offer cross country, volleyball, soccer, ultimate frisbee, basketball, indoor and outdoor track, baseball, softball, and our brand new district-wide football team, the CREC Colts.
It's truly incredible. It's hard to believe, Chad, but adding a sports program has really helped CREC's efforts to cultivate a better future. I know playing sports really played a big role in shaping who I am today. I still remember, like it's yesterday, just going out there with my cleats all laced up, grabbing my bat and glove, and running out there into tryouts, just to realize that I was at football tryouts. And that I had graduated high school 3 years earlier. Yeah, I never really recovered from that.
Well, Mike, I'm pretty sure if you played, you would have learned a lot of important life lessons from your coaches, like how to show up to the right tryouts and to not try out for high school sports at the age of 21. That's a little weird. But seriously, coaches help children grow into adults. And we should all take a moment to recognize all of the CREC coaches out there amongst us. Let's give them all a big hand.
Stand up. Come on, coaches. Stand
Mike, weren't
up.
You a coach?
I was a coach.
Let's give it up for Mike.
It's truly a rewarding experience.
I see you, Dexter, out there, coach of the football team.
All those coaches out there love it. Looks like something's going on over there in the corner.
I don't know what that is. Mist over here.
I wonder, what's that? What's going on? Is Michael Jordan here? Oh, here come Woo! The CREC Colts!
Everyone give it up for our CREC Colts!
everybody. Look at those snazzy green uniforms. They look awesome.
Give it up for our football team, Crack Colts. We're joined by all the players from the team and the coaching staff. So we have PSA coaches from PSA, AAE. Okay. All righty. So we have a few questions for the players. I'm going to ask them to introduce themselves and what school they come from, and then we'll ask them some questions. What's your name?
My name is Zachariah Stevens. I'm from PSA.
All righty. And Zachariah, how do you feel about this upcoming season?
I feel this upcoming season is going to be awesome, man. I mean, oh my Lord. We got so much energy in us. Right now I can feel it.
Give it up for Zachariah, everybody.
All right. What school are you from and what's your name?
My name is DJ Shevlin and I'm from Two Rivers.
All right. DJ, what's your favorite football team?
The Patriots.
Well, that's okay. Nobody's perfect. So what position do you play?
I play tight end and outside linebacker.
Tight end and outside linebacker. That's awesome. Looking forward to the season?
Yes, sir.
I'm looking forward to it, too. Nice job.
All righty. What's your name and what school are you from?
My name is Christopher Rivera, and I'm from MLC.
All righty, MLC. And Christopher, what's the best quality that you think a coach can have?
I think the best quality a coach can have is encouragement.
All righty.
All right. What school are you from and what's your name?
I'm Brandon Hole and I'm from MLC.
All right, MLC. First of all, I love your purple shoes. Secondly, do you think you could beat me in a race?
Nah.
Really?
Maybe. Yeah.
Okay. All right. I like your confidence, but seriously, I mean, what if I was wearing the Batman suit?
Oh, nah, no.
Well,
that cape will get me.
What is up with these capes?
I don't know, but seriously, find me after the show. We're going to settle this. Let's give it up for the Craig Colts, everybody.
All righty, and we're joined by the head coach, Coach Mincy. Everybody give it up for Coach Mincy. Would you be able to let everybody know in the Craig community when your first football game is, where it's at, what time?
First football game, my first official game would be September 13th. Not really sure the time. But I definitely know that it's September 13th. We would love for everyone to come out and support the team, not for just, you know, the sake of coming to a football game, but it's important to these kids. And they've been working hard all summer. They've put in their time. And, you know, as many teachers in here, if we can get you guys to a game, we'll have the biggest crowd in Connecticut. And what I want to do, just like the correct school system is the best school system in Connecticut, we want to have the best football team in Connecticut. So we're going to work as hard as they work on this football field. All these players behind me know that's how hard they got to work in this classroom. So if any of these kids ever give you a problem, you know you can call me at any point in time. But I know my boys, and nobody's going to be a problem, right? But like I said, we would appreciate all the support that we can get. If anybody needs to know, we have t-shirts for sale. On the back of our t-shirts, it says hard-nosed, hard-working, physically and mentally tough. And that's what I'm trying to train these young men to be, just not for football, but for the rest of their lives.
And just so that everyone knows that I was just informed the football game is going to be at 11:30 a.m., and it's going to be at Public Safety Academy. 11:30 a.m. at Public Safety Academy.
Get out there and watch your Craig Colts, everybody.
Let's give it up for the football team, everybody. Thank you all for spending this morning with us. Yes. Hold on, one second.
I forgot to announce my great coaching staff. I have Dexter Williams-Bay, our defensive line running backs coach. Patrick King, who coaches the offensive line and linebackers. Marcus Gales, who coaches the DBs and wide receivers. and the great Rich Russo, who coaches the linebackers and really does nothing on offense.
Just a side note, not to discredit any other athletic program at CREC, make sure you guys check with your local schools to find out when and where those particular games will be hosted and what time. So those soccer, volleyball, track, cross country, I mean. So make sure you guys check those out so you can support all those sports also and your students for the achievement on and off the field. When I think of an athlete, I think the word longevity. It takes serious commitment and dedication to pursue excellence in any field, including athletics. Now, to help us further celebrate the commitment and dedication of the wonderful employees of CREC, please welcome to the stage Mrs. Regina Terrell, Director of Human Resources.
This morning has highlighted what makes CREC so great. It's our people. And you might say the history of CREC is really the history of its people. Our employees are the reason for our continued success, and they also are what makes CREC a great place to work. Each year, we recognize staff who have worked at CREC for 10, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40 years. To our award recipients, we celebrate your longevity and thank you for your commitment to our mission and to the children and families of our region and of our state. At this time, we will announce the longevity nominees in each category. We ask that when your name is called, please come onto the stage to accept your gift and then immediately exit toward the opposite side of the stage. Now we will begin with 10 years of service.
The Longevity Award for 10 years of service is being presented to the following employees: Amato Aliberti, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Susan Buddy, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Lori Campiformio, Montessori Magnet School. Lisa Cordova, Glastonbury East Hartford Elementary School. Ann Cullinan, Data Analysis, Research and Technology. Linda Darcy, Magnet Schools. Renita Ezel, Hartford Region Open Choice Program. Courtney Fishbone, Institute of Teaching and Learning. Felicia Fountain, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Middle School. Kara Gomond, University of Hartford Magnet School. Nancy Gavin, Two Rivers Magnet Middle School. Nancy Getchell, River Street School. John Gentoff, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts High School. Cynthia Granahan, Discovery Academy. Nicole Gamet, Integrated Program Models. Tamika Hastings, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Jennifer Kanzler, Museum Academy. Paula LaBelle, University of Hartford Magnet School. David Mansigian, River Street School. Lisa Moore, River Street School. Peggy Neal, Institute of Teaching and Learning. Wendy Nelson Kaufman, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Roberto Ocasio, River Street School. Emily Ortiz Caratini, River Street School. Stacy Pagliero, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Timothy Perkoski, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Barbara Piotrowski, River Street School. Beth Rich, Medical Professions and Teacher Preparation Academy. Claudette Rose, Montessori Magnet School. Brenda Royce, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Diana Saunders, River Street School. Ann Shemkovitz, University of Hartford Magnet School. Gregory Schenk, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering Middle School. Marie Szymanski, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. Michael Sirois, Academy of Aerospace and Engineering High School. Judith Snelling, Two Rivers Magnet Middle School. Stacy Stefanovich, Public Safety Academy. Regina Toussaint, Integrated Program Models. Rosanna Fasal, Metropolitan Learning Center for Global and International Studies. David Wu, Data Analysis, Research and Technology. The Longevity Award for 20 years of service is being presented to the following employees. Donna Brilla, Integrated Program Models. Evelyn Colon, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Dana Flamia Denault, Integrated Program Models. Rosa Flores, Positive Parenting Program. Pura Gomez, Soundbridge. Robert Copps, River Street School. Thomas McAuliffe, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Rotasha McBride, Data Analysis, Research and Technology. Jean Moore, Glastonbury East Hartford Elementary School. Carol Spencer, Birth to Three. Ann Sullivan Harris, River Street School. David Swekla, River Street School. The Longevity Award for 25 years of service is being presented to the following employees. Carol Auclair, Integrated Program Models. Maureen Boge, Data Analysis, Research and Technology. Sonia Campbell, River Street School. John Costello, Two Rivers Magnet Middle School. Susan Kazmarzik, Integrated Program Models. Nancy Krosick, Integrated Program Models. Audrey Lamy, River Street School. Patricia Linares, Creck Central Copy Center. Dawn Pete, Integrated Program Models. Deborah Walsh, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts High School. Joyce West, Integrated Program Models. The Longevity Award for 30 years of service is being presented to the following employees. Michael McMahon, John J. Allison Jr. Polaris Center. Susan Wisniak, Soundbridge.
All right, everybody, it's raffle time. Woo, winning stuff. I'll need my handy dandy iPad since this is all off registration. I gotta see who won. So this first sponsor is the Hartford Wolfpack, and I would love this prize. I'm a big hockey fan,
I would too, so if you need a guest.
Yeah, we're available. So the first prize, a suite for any regular season Wolfpack game, goes to, where's International Magnet School? Where is it? There we are. Okay, Matthew Whitaker.
Stan, lucky you.
Congratulations. Don't forget your MCs when you go to that game. Our second sponsor is from Pike Company. Pike Company. This prize is a duffel bag full of goodies. I love goodies. And the winner is, where's my Metropolitan Learning Center?
This is a conspiracy.
Elijah Rivers. Congratulations. Just so you know, you're splitting what's in that bag with me. Our next sponsor is from School Messenger. This is a Google Chromecast, and I gotta tell you, I have one of these things, and it's pretty awesome. I don't even watch regular TV anymore. I just watch this thing over and over. So where is River Street? Woo, all the way back there. Okay, Michael Henderson, congratulations, from River Street. Our next sponsor is Crex Integrated Program Models. This is a gift basket. The winner is Tammy Harmon. Where are you, Tammy? Tammy Harmon. Wave. Go like this.
We can't see you, Tammy.
Oh, we got her. There she is. Hey, how you doing? Congratulations. That's a nice looking basket. Okay, and now the raffle. Okay.
So Mike and I already told you we really want to go to the Wolfpack game with Mike Whitaker. You know, you can look at us. So this next award, we have a raffle, and it's for all the schools. So this handy-dandy basket has your school program in it. I'm going to hold the basket. Mike's going to pick a name, and the winner will get the staff and faculty of that particular school will get tickets to a Wolfpack game.
I'm a little scared just in case it is MLC. People are going to riot.
So
here we go. The winner is Hartford Region Open Choice. Congratulations.
Could the principal, well, the leader of Hartford Regional Choice stand?
Back in there.
Darn.
Can't win them all, Chad.
I tried aerospace.
Chad, Falstaff is coming to a close here. Mike Henderson, where are you?
Mike Henderson? He's right there standing up.
There we go.
The back.
I promise, it's a Google Chromecast. It's pretty cool.
He's right this way, to the right.
I see him.
Wait, can you wave again? All the way in the last aisle.
All right, well, Chad, Falstaff, kind of coming to a close here. We're almost done.
I know. It's been awesome. It's been great with you guys. It's been great with Mike.
I've had a really good time so far, but how do you feel right now?
I think I shared the same sentiment as the superintendent of Harvard Public Schools. I feel happy.
Yeah, I feel pretty.
I'm so happy. What about you guys? How do you feel?
I feel pretty happy too, actually, to be honest. This is a pretty nice fitting hat. I like my Batman one better, but I gotta tell you, I'm pretty happy right now. What do you think of this one?
I like it. It's a little Pharrell-esque. It's befitting. Yeah.
I don't care. All right, very good. Looks like I'm the only introvert in the room. Good. Did you see Mary Ellen Manning up there? Wow, what a surprise, what a surprise. All right, so what a great day. I want to take a moment to express my admiration and appreciation for the Longevity Award recipients, to our Distinguished Service Award winner, Gerard Barrett, our paraprofessional of the year, Maria Perez, our manager of the year.
Great job, thanks a lot.
Our manager of the year, Aura Alvarado, and our teacher of the year, Joe DiPasqua. Congratulations. So these individuals exemplify what CREC is all about. I also want to thank Mike Collins from the CREC Metropolitan Learning Center in Chad Weaver Bay for the CREC Academy of the Aerospace and Engineering. What a great job. Thank you. Moreover, I want to commend the Departments of Communication and the Fall Staff Planning Committee and the many volunteers and employee ambassadors, student performers, and all of those featured in the videos today. Those videos were remarkable. Excellent, excellent. And a very special thank you to our major sponsors, ORNL, B&L Companies, Wells Fargo and Transamerica, Project Technologies Group, and Nora Cupcake Companies. Make sure you get a cupcake on your way out. And thanks to all of our sponsors and vendors who supported the success of today's events. Without their support, Fall Staff would not be possible. I leave you with this. Remember, our mantra is to serve the best interests of children and families. Our ethos is manifested in an intense commitment to eliminate the disparities of opportunities among children, families, and adults, and to eliminate the so-called achievement and socioeconomic gaps. As always, I urge all of you to be active and to be involved, continue to learn and continue to grow. Strive for a balanced life that recognizes the importance of work, play, time for friends, time for loved ones, and time for reflection and your own spiritual renewal. And above all, know that your work here is highly valued and truly does make a difference in the lives and the futures of families and children of the Capital Region and beyond. Be bold, be courageous, do great things, do things the correct way. Thank you and best wishes for a great year. Now, I ask you to pause for just 1 minute. The MCs want to close out the meeting. I especially want to appreciate, I'm watching the door, right? I especially want to appreciate the good spirit and attention for everyone who sat in the back rows. Thank you very much. You did a great job today. Okay, MCs.
Before everybody left, I really wanted to thank, this is kind of like off script, I really want to thank Ara, Jessica, Julia, and Kelly for all their hard work. The community, we've been working with them throughout the whole summer to really put this on, and they put a lot of work. I also like to thank the CREC ambassadors, the committee for Fall Staff. I want to thank our sponsors. I would like to thank the CREC football team and their coaches. I also like to thank you. Without you, this would not be possible, and we're here to celebrate you all, so give yourselves a round of applause for all the hard work, the dedication, the excellence that you do. Aerospace, love you guys.
You stay classy, Capital Region Education Council. Please, Longevity Award winners, don't forget to pick up your award on the way out, and don't forget your cupcake on the way out. Any unclaimed cupcakes, go home with Chad and I, so get your cupcake. Come on. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everyone.